Good day, Minecraftians. Purple Mentat here, bringing you episode 24 of my Regrowth Let's Play. Today, I want to do two things. I want to get this runic altar. You'll notice I cleared out the other one. It's currently hanging out in my Botania chest. A little bit better automated, which we have an open crate floating up there to help with that. And I want to start some steel production. So, step one, where did my assembly halo go? We need to make a couple of things. I want a repeater, which I'm going to need a couple of redstone torches for. And then that repeater is going to help me build the hourglass from Automagy, using some sand, some wood slabs, and some glass paints. Which it's just not going to cooperate with, is it? Of course not. Too much stuff in the inventory, things get uncooperative. Happens all the... Oh, you know what? Nope. That's my bad there. I have to actually make the repeater, not just talk about it and get the components for it. That helps a little bit anyway. There we are. Now, where was that hourglass again? You'll note there's also a magic hourglass, but that takes some Thaumcraft research to unlock, and we're not going to get into Thaumcraft just yet. The other item I need is the dispenser from Vanilla. And you might think, what? Vanilla item? This thing's not all that useful. You already have the open crate. What do you need a dispenser for? Well, it's pretty simple, really. Botania has added a number of additions to what the dispenser can do. In particular, if I stick... Oop. Wrong direction. If I stick the dispenser right there, facing the runic altar, and I give it the wand of the forest, every time a redstone pulse hits that thing, it is going to go ahead and right-click that wand on that runic altar. Which means, if I were to, for example, set up a slime ball, two sand, a melon, I believe it's fire and air? Earth and air. An air rune and a rune of earth, when those drop from the open crate and hit the runic altar, they automagically go into the floaty mode. That means they're ready to be used for crafting. So let me go grab a button. Who's got my button? There's one. If I were to stick the button on the side of here and right click it, it starts the crafting process. That's exactly what I want, but I don't want to have to manually right-click the button because that completely defeats the point. Instead, we're going to set up this little hourglass to do it for us. And the way that's going to happen is we're just going to make a simple loop of redstone and put another one there. Now, let's see what happens if I toss my living rock into the item hopper. It falls on top of the runic altar and waits. Now, if I click this hourglass, give it a right-click, you'll notice the timer is set to 5 seconds. I can't seem to change that. But that's okay, I only need it at 5 seconds. That's a perfect amount of time. As you can see, it pulses every 5 seconds, and because the redstone is feeding back into it, it then flips over and pulses again. So this thing is going to go ahead and pulse my dispenser every 5 seconds. Now, if I grab another rune of air and another rune of earth, and I input the materials to make another rune of summer into this thing, including a living rock. Well, it's going to go ahead and craft that for me, and all I need to do is give it the right materials in the right order. That is a significant improvement over the situation that I had before. So now we can go ahead and make our rutile seeds the same way. We can put in our strong essence, our essence seed, fire, earth, winter, summer. Earth, fire, winter, summer, and the block of impure titanium. And next time it clicks. There we go. Haha! I like it. It's not the best, but it does a plenty fine job for my purposes right now. And yes, I'm going to need to get myself another couple of living wood. Actually, I need another wand of the forest entirely, and that takes 3 of the living wood twigs. And you know what? We're going to make this one You know what, we'll stick with the classic purple and yellow. I like that. As you can hear, my seeds should be complete. Fantastic. Excellent. Pretty happy about that. I'm liking that system so far. Rutile seeds, pick reward. I'm going to take the 6 strong essence. Thank you very much. It's going to be more useful for me than the extra seeds. So now that we have the ability to produce an infinite amount of titanium, I don't have to worry about using it ever. We're going to get that improving itself on the crops. You'll note that I did set up my coal crops over here. I'm looking forward to the day that I don't have to harvest those manually. And I've got some ideas for some alternative or different, hopefully improved mana generation. We'll get into those later. Okay, so let's see where we're going with the sheets of titanium. We're going to need 4 blaze essence. We're going to need a good pile of nether essence. And let's see where those infernal bricks are. Infernal bricks are made from fitted infernal stone, which are made from infernal blocks, which are made from nether brick and soul sand. And the nether brick, of course, you can make with the essence of the nether. So I've got some soul sand over here. We'll hang on to it. It's not like I can't make more. Let's see. How much of this do I need? The infernal bricks are used to make the blast furnace blocks. It's going to take me 2 infernal brick per 9. So I only need 8 infernal bricks. Okay, that's not so bad. So I only need like 1 craft of the nether brick and 1 craft of the soul sand would also be good. Be nice if it started on the shapeless crafting for this, but that's all right. I'll survive. We'll go ahead and make 2. Who knows? Maybe someday I'll want to make another set of blast furnaces, so I'll go ahead and make these 16 infernal bricks. Now we need to get some of them brick construction blocks. I don't know if I have any left over, but I do know that I have plenty of burnt brick to make more. Construct. Nope. Nope. Okay, that's fine. Not a worry. We'll go grab our iron bars. And actually, I'm gonna need more of them. I need to get more iron production going. I'm running low. That's a problem. Burnt brick, brick construction blocks. Go ahead and make all 6. No, I need more than that. I need even more. Jeez. No problem. Here we go. Now, go ahead and make 4 more. And now we can go ahead and make our blast furnace like this. Oh, whoops. We need to change the infernal blocks into infernal bricks, which is just putting them into the crafting grid twice. Not a problem. So, last furnace bricks. We should be able to shift click this recipe, and we can. 36 of them. Fantastic. Next step in the quest chain. In what the world enables. Ooh, 1 quest with unclaimed rewards. That's actually all we needed to do. We will get 4 titanium and 4 steel ingots. Fantastic. Awesome. So now if I really want to, I can make lots and lots of steel pretty easily. We're just going to go ahead and set this up next to my... how do I want to do the 6? You know what? Let's be cheeky about it. It can live right on top of my coke oven for the time being. Because why not? To construct this, as it says, it needs to be a 3x4x3 and it needs to be hollow. Which means we ignore that middle. We make kind of a donut shape for 2 spaces. And then, if you've built it correctly, you'll get that little window on the bottom. We're going to get ourselves some iron. Ooh. Right. Iron. We were having that conversation, weren't we? Alright, let me get some iron seeds planted and get myself some more iron ingots going, because I seem to have finally run through all of the ones that I made earlier in the series. I shall return once I have the iron I need to actually make myself some steel. See you soon. Alrighty, while things are processing over there, let's try out my idea for some better mana generation, or at least some simpler mana generation that I don't have to pay as much attention to, which is effectively the same thing as far as I am concerned. I'm gonna want a whole bunch of this living rock, so luckily I have enough of it. Largely because it's just pretty and that's what I want to use, not for any actual functional purpose. We're gonna put a striped transport pipe there and an obsidian transport pipe behind it. We're gonna make ourselves another open crate because I need one, which is gonna take a couple of living wood. We're running out of both living wood and living rock. That's not a good sign. Better do something about that. Living wood planks, make an open crate. And I'm going to want a hopper from my tools chest. Ooh, I'm out of hoppers too. This is getting really exciting. Maybe I won't be able to do this after all. Not yet, anyway. Need to get some iron first. Why is it that the episode that I have all of these cool ideas is also the episode where everything just is a little bit of a pain? That's all right. I don't mind. Not that much. There we go. Make some quick iron. Turn that iron into some quick ore metal stuff. And we're going to go ahead and get this thing pumping because I know that there's exactly enough iron in there to produce blocks, which is what I'm after. You know what? I probably have a pile of essence of iron over here, don't I? I wouldn't say a pile, but I've got at least some. See if we end up with a nice multiple of 9. Nope. 2 extra iron ore. That's okay. We can deposit that. Oh, hey, look at that. I have multiple stacks of iron ore. This is what happens when you get so much stuff going on that you forget what you're doing all the time. It's not good. It's not pretty. Almost. Okay. Be back soon once that turns into actual resources. Alright, I once again have iron. So, we have a stack of coal coke in the blast furnace, and we're going to toss a stack of iron in there as well. And that's going to start turning into steel. Not very quickly, but as you can see, one iron ingot will turn into steel in 1,280 ticks, which, when divided by 20 into seconds, gets us 64 seconds. It takes about a minute per steel. So for an entire stack of iron, 64 iron at 64 seconds each gets us 68 minutes and a little change. So yeah, it's going to take a while. Now the other side of things, coal coke burns for about 4 times as long as regular coal, but only 2 times as long in railcraft items, I believe. Anyway, bottom line, it's going to take more than one stack of coal coke to be able to process one stack of iron. I believe it's going to take 2 full stacks. We'll be able to find out in a moment here. Yep, we end up with 1 steel just as it starts burning the 3rd piece of coal coke. There you go. So it is going to take 2 full stacks of coal coke to make 1 full stack of steel ingots. Luckily, this is not the best method for making steel that is available in the pack. It's just the method we have available right now. Alright, so I want to get this mana experiment underway. We're going to put an open crate right above that obsidian pipe. And we're going to put the hopper on top of the open crate. And on top of the hopper is going to go a chest. In that chest is going to go dynamite, but not quite yet. First, I want to build a bit of a device to limit the speed of the hopper. To do that, we're going to put some living rock right there, and we're going to stick a redstone torch right like that. So now the hopper's turned off. It cannot function. It will do nothing. That is what we want in this circumstance. We actually want to take this living rock away. I believe like that will do what I want. Now, if I have this figured right, this second hourglass that I made can be placed like so to create a 5-second timer. And when it outputs here, it will temporarily power that block. Huh, it's not outputting there. Well, that's an issue. Don't know why it's not outputting that side. A little bit odd. It outputs this side just fine, but it does not output that side. It looks like it only outputs from the... Oh, or is it? Hang on. Give me just a second. Nope. It looks like it only outputs from the braced sides, as it were. As such, we're going to need to pick it up and put it down a couple of times to make sure it's facing the direction I want, which is like so. Now, when it outputs here, it should power that block. And it does, for just an instant, enough to turn the redstone torch off long enough for this hopper to output a single item. Now, if I toss a bunch of TNT into this chest, give it a moment here, one more pulse, it will drop a TNT onto the obsidian pipe, get placed in the world next to that, explode, creating mana in one of these entropiniums. Uh-oh. Well, that didn't work out. Largely because the mana spreader that I was using was not able to transfer mana to the mana pool fast enough. Ha. Alright, I'm gonna clean up this mess, and then we're gonna set this up in a much better way. Back soon. Alright, since we just had that explosion, I've done cleaning up most of it, but it is decided that this is as good a time as any to start moving our Botania stuff a little bit closer to what's going to be the new home of this world anchor. So let's go ahead and get the world anchor placed first, and then we'll worry about exactly where to put the Botania stuff. Specifically, I want to take a look at the chunks over here for the farms. I probably should have done this beforehand, but good. All right, so the farms are entirely contained in chunks that will be loaded if I have my world anchor in this chunk here. Excellent, because that will load this one and this one, this one, and that will give me here, here, and here to play with Botania. I can work with that. That seems like a pretty decent setup. Let's go ahead and get our Ender Pearls back in there. Oh, nice. It remembered how much time was left in there. I like that. Good machine. Now, I need to, of course, transfer a bunch of mana away from my... Why do I even have you on hand? Away from my mana pools and into my mana tablets. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and shut down the nature pylons and these sparks. Everything's got to go. Shift right click to get rid of the sparks. Nature pylon, you're going to have to break with your pickaxe. And we're going to have some serious inventory issues, but luckily we have... Oh, well, look at that. This guy saved a bunch of my flowers and such. Good. Nice, Hopper Hawk. Put these away. We're going to have to move everything from here over to the other area. It's going to be a bit of a thing. All of this is broken down with an axe. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get... Hopper Hawk is a little overeager. He's grabbing my mana tablet. I wonder. There's got to be a better way to automate when those guys are allowed to do their thing. Put you there. I need to grab you. In any case, this is all stuff that I can fairly easily do off camera. On camera, I would like to get Darn it. That was so close. I hate this thing. Just all of everything about it. There. There. Good. Just stop. You are on the wrong binding. There. Jeez. Nothing wants to cooperate right now. Why's everything got to be so contrary? Anyway, there. Finally, we'll just leave that alone. Time to move on. Go do something else. Okay, so the next quest in the tech line is probably going to be making some power, because we're starting to get to the point where having a lot of redstone flux would be relatively useful. So we're going to hit up what the world enables and go for full steam ahead. Steam is a great way to produce kinetic energy in engines, but you're starting to find that the hobbyist steam engines aren't cutting it anymore. Maybe it's time to up the ante and produce steam in larger quantities. Let's start with building a dedicated steam boiler. To build a boiler, you'll need a base of fireboxes and with the boiler tanks placed on top. They come in various sizes, the smallest of which is one tank on top of a single firebox. Solid-fueled fireboxes run off of furnace fuels. So, let's take a look at the fireboxes. The solid-fueled firebox made with a furnace, a fire charge, which can be created with blaze powder, gunpowder, and your choice of coal or charcoal, and brick. No problem, right? Let's go ahead and get this gone. It looks like I have a bit of gunpowder on hand, so we'll just grab one blaze powder and one of the charcoal that everyone was so kind to tell me over and over and over again I missed in the other episode. Ooh, hot topic. Why did those end up on the ground? Not only on the ground, but on the ground too far for me to grab it. Sigh. Alright, solid-fueled firebox complete. Now, the low-pressure boiler tank is going to require iron plates. Luckily, we have a couple of iron plates hanging around somewhere. Probably got stuffed in a chest, didn't it? There we go. We're just going to go ahead and make... Well, we'll make the one boiler tank for now and see what it asks us to do next. Crafting task. Commercial steam engine. The commercial steam engine produces twice as much RF per tick as the hobbyist engine, but as a trade-off, doesn't have space for an internal boiler, so steam must be supplied from an external steam boiler structure. So, the commercial steam engine produces 40 RF per tick at the cost of 20 millibuckets of steam per tick. It's going to require iron gears and iron plates. I'm glad I didn't use them all. In fact, we're going to make two of those, because we can. Is that our Buildcraft? No, this is our Buildcraft. We're going to need 1, 2, 3, 4. And I need more iron. Again. That's okay. I've had this guy producing more iron for me for a bit. Oh, a little bit more iron. 4 blocks. Not exactly a kick in the teeth, but not ideal either. Assembly halo. We're going to grab 4 iron gears. And then we should be able to make you. We need pistons and glass. Well, I know that glass is in here. And I know that I have a couple of pistons in my tool bag. Excellent. 2 commercial steam engines. Fantastic. Quest book. Quest complete. And we get 16 golden fluid pipes for our efforts. Now, if we want to make the easiest use of the steam boiler, it's really a simple case of toss down solid fueled boiler firebox, toss a boiler tank on top of it, and we have the world's smallest steam boiler. It can only hold 4 buckets of water, and it's not going to be able to produce a whole lot of steam. However, it will work pretty well automagically. Just going to grab 4 buckets of water here. Show you how easily this can work. Next time, we'll definitely be building a larger, more exciting boiler, probably using the steel that we're producing. Speaking of steel, hang on a moment. I need a chest out of tools. Then we can make a hopper. I don't know why I ran over here with the assembly halo in my inventory. Now we can stick the hopper on the blast furnace, grab another stack or five of coal coke, toss that in there. Just to keep everything nice and fueled. Excellent. All right. Now, one other thing we can do with some coal coke. We're going to use about half of what we have left. I need to get harvesting more coal. We're going to toss a couple of bits of it into the steam boiler. You'll note that it begins cooking and the pressure, the temperature begins going up immediately. You'll also note that the steam boiler has up to four spaces in its inventory for fuel. So if I were to grab a couple of stacks, a couple of bits of charcoal over here, almost stacks, not entirely full stacks, and I were to shift click those in, well, they're going to end into that area instead. Now, the steam boiler will begin producing steam now that it has enough heat. However, if it ever runs out of water, you need to let it cool down completely, because if you add more water to a hot boiler, you will get a gargantuan explosion. Also, I believe the thing will explode just on its own if it happens to have too much water in it. Now, you've got two options for extracting the steam and using it in the engines. You can simply stick an engine on the side, and if you use your Buildcraft wrench to turn it properly, which is apparently easier said than done. Hang on. You know what we're going to have to do? We're going to have to pursue one of the other quests while we're doing this, just so that I can demonstrate things to you properly. In the quest book, if I go on over to Better Kinetics, with the discovery of redstone, you're able to produce much larger amounts of kinetic energy. As such, it is a bit of a waste to have one of these more powerful engines attached to but a single machine each. To counter this, you found a way to rig the pipe system to be able to conduct the produced energy by lining the pipe with redstone. Wooden kinesis pipe and cobblestone kinesis pipe await us. So, we're going to need a little bit of redstone. And we're going to need some of our wood transport pipes and some of our cobblestone transport pipes. That's stone. Cobblestone. Like so. Now, the cobblestone transport pipes can move 80 redstone flux per tick, which is double what the steam engine produces. The wooden kinesis pipe can have a power input of 320 redstone flux per tick. I stick the wooden kinesis pipe next to the commercial steam engine, and then I right-click the steam engine, it will turn to face the kinesis pipe. The other option you have, you'll note that the wooden kinesis pipes will not connect, is to use a fluid pipe. I should be able to use a golden fluid pipe. Where did those go? Here they are. 80 millibuckets a tick transport. Stick it right on the side of that, and the boiler will happily output directly into the fluid pipe for you, with you not needing to actively do anything. Now, because these are Buildcraft engines, they do need a redstone signal to be able to function. As such, we're going to toss a couple of redstone torches underneath these, and once you do, they start allowing steam in and begin generating power. As you can see, quite a bit of redstone flux begins generating already. Now, if I have some cobblestone kinesis pipes feeding my power into my rolling machine, well, there you go. Now, it has an outlet. Excellent, huh? So if I were to take, say, some of this steel to make some steel plates, which is definitely on my list of wants, it is now spending power. It can't quite collect the power as fast as it's spending it because of the limitations on these engines, but these engines are doing their best. And as you can see, as it generates power, it produces those lines that run through the kinesis pipes. Those are the path the power is taking. Kind of cool, in my opinion. All right, just took a look at the time. We are 30 minutes in, and I think that for once I'm actually going to end on time. Ooh, claim reward, 16 quartz kinesis pipes and 8 redstone, 640 RF for tick transmission. That's a heck of a lot better, isn't it? In fact, I'd be able to take 2 full inputs with no trouble at all. In any case, that's going to be all the time we have for today. As you can see, we've opened up some extra options that we're going to need to be looking into soon. And I believe next time I should be in good shape to work on what the world is built from, creating the cobalt seeds, finally. Yes. Hope you've enjoyed the episode, folks. If so, please let me know in the comments below and leave me a thumbs up. If not, let me know what I can do better and leave a thumbs down. Either way, you'll be interacting to ensure I continue showing up in your subscriber feed, and I'll see you next time.